Hey guys, I'm Brett Berry and welcome back to Math Hacks. Today on Math Hacks, I am showing you all the ins and outs for rationalizing the denominator. Rationalizing the denominator is one of those problems that just shows up all over the place. You may be asked to rationalize the denominator as a problem in and of itself, or you might find yourself needing to rationalize the denominator in the process of simplifying an answer to a geometry, trigonometry, or calculus problem. But no matter what course you're coming from, today's goal is to get you up to speed. Rationalizing the denominator simply means that we want to get any roots that are in the denominator out of the denominator. To do this, we need to multiply by a form of 1 that will help us cancel out this square root 3. So what you need to do is multiply by square root 3 over square root 3 to get rid of the square root 3 in the denominator. Now we can do this because the square root of 3 over the square root of 3 simply equals 1. And we know that anything multiplied by 1 remains the same. So although we're making the fraction look different, we're not altering it in any way. So I'm going to go ahead and multiply the numerators together and the denominators together. Now we need to multiply the square root of 3 times the square root of 3. And we know that the square root of 9 is simply 3. That is the same as 7 over 8 square root 3, except we altered how it looked so that the square root was no longer in the denominator and instead is in the numerator. And that is rationalizing the denominator. In this problem, we have 2 square root 3 over square root 5. Now a common mistake here would be to try to multiply by the square root of 3. We need to make sure that we are multiplying by the square root that we want to get rid of. And we want to get rid of the square root in the denominator. So I'm going to multiply the top and bottom by square root of 5. Again, this is a form of 1, so it's a totally legal move. Multiplying the numerators and denominators together, we get. And we're almost there. All we need to do now is go ahead and take the square root of 25, which is 5. We can't simplify any further. And we have succeeded at getting the radical out of the denominator, so that is our final answer. Now this is a bit more of a tricky problem because we have not only a square root in the denominator, but we have that square root being added to a whole number. And this just makes it a little more difficult because no longer can we just multiply by square root 2 over square root 2. Let's go ahead and see what happens when we do that, and that'll show us why we can't do this. So, multiplying by square root 2 over square root 2, like we did in the last two examples, we see that here we have to distribute the square root 2 in the bottom. And when we do that, we get 4 square root 2 plus the square root of 4, which is 2. Now that helped us to get rid of this square root 2, but it introduced a new square root 2 here where we multiplied it with the whole number. So this does not work in this situation. So how do we get around this issue where we want to get rid of a square root, but not introduce a new square root into the denominator? To do that, you need to multiply by something called the conjugate. Conjugate is simply the same binomial expression with this sign switched. So for this one, I'll change it into a minus sign. If it were a minus sign, I'd switch it to a plus sign. So the conjugate of 4 plus square root 2 is 4 minus square root 2. Now the way FOIL works, when we multiply this binomial by its conjugate, we're going to lose those middle terms and we're gonna be left with whole numbers, which is exactly what we want in this situation because we're trying to get rid of the square roots in the denominator. Here, once again, I'm following the rule that I have to multiply by a form of 1 so I don't alter the equation. And of course, anything over itself, even if it's kind of nasty like this, is still equal to 1. So the top, I'm just going to multiply the 1 through, and I get 4 minus square root 2. On the bottom, I want to make sure to add parentheses around this, indicating that I need to FOIL these two binomials together in order to multiply these expressions out. Okay, let's go ahead and FOIL now. So 4 times 4 is 16. Square root 2 times positive 4 is positive 4 square root 2. 4 times negative square root 2 is minus 4 square root 2. And lastly, square root 2 times negative square root 2 is negative square root 4. Now our positive 4 square root 2 and negative 4 square root 2 cancel each other out. And minus square root 4 is simply minus 2. So the denominator becomes 16 minus 2, which is 14. I'm going to go ahead and rewrite the answer now. So to recap, whenever you have a binomial and you're trying to rationalize the denominator, you must multiply by the conjugate of the denominator over itself. So in this problem, we multiplied 4 plus square root 2 by 4 minus square root 2. And when we FOILed that out, we noticed that anything that had square root 2s remaining in it canceled out, and we were left with only whole numbers, instead moving our square root part up into the numerator. I hope you found today's lesson useful. If so, I would really appreciate it if you give me a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. And if you want to keep practicing rationalizing the denominator, look for the free PDF that I have linked in the comment box below. Till next time, I'm Brett Berry, and this is Math Hacks.